Welcome back.
All right, we're hanging out with Gregory and Mitchell from ASAP Science. Now, guys, we are big fans of you guys.
Ah, oh, right, likewise.
Yeah, right. Back
all that you do. You're actually legitimately scientific, which we respect.
Yeah, you guys are too in many ways.
In many ways, in some ways. In a few ways.
Boiled for safety.
True.
That is scientific.
That's scientific.
Right.
Now, I'm curious, we've parodied you guys a number of times on the show, but we didn't tell you we were gonna do it.
No, you did it.
So you just saw it.
Why we're here to collect our royalties.
Oh, okay.
I thought
this has gotten awkward.
Okay, no, but when we first saw it.
You can take the mugs with you.
Thank you.
You'll take me.
When we first saw it, though, I first remember, because they always start very like real and similar, and we were like, oh, wow. They just took our idea.
They're like, truly
doing this. Like, I'm pretty
that
sure.
That one
like,
looks really familiar.
Like, hey, we're gonna get those YouTube people and we're gonna have a throwdown. Then it progressed and we were like, oh, this is so fun.
Yeah. Like they are truly amazing.
And they become absurd
and so
and
dark.
They become.
And so as a result, we really decided that we wanted to do a parody of your parody, if that's all right.
I don't think you need to ask our permission. I think we firmly
established. Yeah, you didn't ask our permission.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
So
most
sure.
Of the agreement.
Shall we watch that?
Sure.
All right, well, let's watch our version of Amazingly Amazing Science.
Okay.
It's time for Amazingly Amazing Science. What happens when you get angry?
When something triggers your anger, a part of your brain called the amygdala sets off an alarm.
Before the more reasonable parts of your brain can chime in, this alarm wakes up your adrenal glands and causes them to start flooding your system with adrenaline.
You experience a burst of energy, extra blood pumps through your muscles, and now you're ready to fight.
Think of it this way. Your brain is like an apocalypse bunker. Inside your bunker brain, there lives a trigger-happy Kid Rock for President-supporting amygdala. Let's call him Link.
One morning, Link wakes up and jumps out of his leaky waterbed because he thinks he smells smoke.
A normal, sensible, smart man would go outside and check for the source of the smoke before jumping to a conclusion. But Link is not normal or sensible, and he's definitely not smart, so he immediately hits the bunker's special panic button.
The panic button sets off an alarm that wakes up an obnoxiously tall adrenal gland. We'll call him Rhett.
Just like Link, Rhett is too lazy and self-absorbed to double-check things, so he immediately releases his swarm of messenger pigeons, all of whom are trained to fly to every other bunker in the land, alerting their inhabitants that the world is ending.
Unfortunately, that chinless praying mantis Rhett had only been feeding his pigeons out of an expired Jim Baker bucket. Chunks start falling off of these birds like Rhett's skin during a psoriasis outbreak, because it turns out they've all contracted a zombie plague. What a hypothetical moron.
Rhett's disgusting, busted pigeons rub up on every other apocalypse prepper's pigeons, eventually spreading the bird zombie plague to every bird on Earth.
Meanwhile, Rhett and Link are running around their bunker fighting over who gets the last lock of Jimmy Fallon's hair. Yeah, they stole his hair. It's a real doozy of a fight because Link is physically incapable of compromise.
Rhett's running into walls because his 40-year-old eyes can't perceive depth anymore, while Link is crying like a little baby in the corner, but only out of his right eye. There's something really wrong with his left eye. I wonder if it's related to the fact that his hair has gone completely gray. He's been dying it for years, kids.
Yeah, and Rhett's nose, why is there always a bat in the cave? It's like the man is entirely composed of dried nasal mucus. That's a scientific way of saying boogers. If I were Rhett, I'd just say boogers because I don't understand the basic principles of the scientific method. And I think Francis Bacon is the new breakfast sandwich available at Hardee's.
Speaking of meat to avoid, Rhett's pigeon plague spurs the actual human zombie apocalypse, and the world devolves into a barren wasteland, unilaterally ruled by the one animal unaffected by the disease, aardvarks.
Oh, and by the way, Link has mouth herpes.
This has been Amazingly Amazing Science.
Okay. So you're not harboring any resentment at all.
How do you really feel, guys?
You really did your homework.
Parody us one more time.
All right.
Say, that was amazing.
That's fair.
That's fair.
Cheers.
Four-way
cheers.
Toast.
Four-way. Ooh. All right. Click through to see if we can guess some of the stupidest questions ever Googled on Google.
Go way back with us with our Rhett and Link friendship tea, available at mythical.store.